Equalizer's Rockstar Roadie is designed to remove most of the guesswork from the repair process. Roadie works by displacing entrapped air and injecting transparent liquid resin into the pit of the brake. So the first thing we want to do is we want to go ahead and clean the brake. We're actually going to use our scribe or our probe, and we're going to remove the broken particles. So I'm going to go ahead and put my safety glasses on and put my nitriles on. So like I said, I'm going to go ahead and go in here and I'm going to take out the broken glass with my probe. Get a paper towel and wipe it off. Then I'm going to go ahead and just put my finger over the area, kind of wet it a little bit and clean around the area where my pad is going to come in contact with the glass. So I'm going to use a pad. I'm going to remove the backing on the pad, and I'm going to place that right over the brake. This is so that I make sure that I am centered. And I'm going to go around the perimeter, making sure I get good adhesion to the surface. All right. And I'm going to take secondary cover off the pad. Then I'm going to get my pedestal and I'm going to remove again the backing off of the pedestal. And I'm going to place this directly over it. This is how I center it over the brake. So I'm going to make sure I align it. Now I know I'm exactly where I should be. And again, I'm going to go ahead and put pressure around the pedestal. So this way I get the best adhesion. So the next thing that I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and get my resin and fill it to this line here. Go ahead and open the cap. Which comes out to about four drops. I'm going to get my flow regulator, place it on top, twist it. And because I'll be probably working in areas where maybe there might be ultraviolet light, I want to make sure that I have the ultraviolet light protector, and it goes right over that. The next thing that I'll do is I'll go ahead and connect the hose into the flow regulator. Now I'm going to go ahead and place the hose onto the injector and make sure I've got good contact. Now what I've done is I've lowered the valve, and you can hear the air flowing through. So now I'm going to go ahead and pull vacuum. I'm going to turn the lever in the upward position and I'm going to pull the plunger back and let the notch hold onto the wire. Then I'm going to go ahead and release, turning this valve to the left, and I'm going to put the plunger back in, closing the valve again and creating the extra vacuum. And we're gonna go ahead and let it sit for 5 minutes. If the brake is reacting, I can see the air bubbles being extracted from the brake. You can actually see the bubbles coming to the surface. That's a good sign, because now the resin will be on the bottom and all the trapped air that's in the brake is coming to the surface. All right, after 5 minutes have gone by, I'm gonna go ahead and release the vacuum. I'm gonna open the valve. Then I'm going to turn the notch so that you can see the third notch. I'm gonna close the valve and I'm gonna actually put pressure. I'm gonna go ahead and hold it, and then I'm gonna turn it till it locks into the spring. So now that we've waited 5 minutes on the vacuum face, I'm gonna go ahead and inspect it. Now the brake looks really good. If I have to give it extra time, you can leave it for another 2 minutes if you'd like, or another 5 minutes. I'm gonna go ahead and release the pressure. Open the valve. I'm gonna remove the hose. I'm going to remove the ultraviolet light cover and the flow regulator. Then I'm gonna go ahead and use a razor blade, and I'm going to start to remove the actual pedestal. Now there are some grooves on the actual pedestal. This is so this way it helps you remove the pedestal from the glass. Put a little pressure on it. All right. Now that I've done that, I'm going to go ahead and get all that off of there. Wipe that off. Get a Mylar square, and I'm going to put a drop of pit filler right on top of the brake. And I'm going to go ahead and level it off, flatten it out, so that there's no air pockets. We want to make sure that the Mylar square is over the brake. No air is trapped in there. No air is getting to the resin or the pit filler, and it's going to help in the process of curing the brake. I'm going to go ahead and turn on my ultraviolet light, put it right over it, and we're going to let it sit for 5 to 10 minutes and let it cure. Now that the resin is cured for 5 minutes, I'm going to go ahead and take the lamp off, turn it off, and I'm going to go ahead and take the Mylar square off. As you can see, there's nothing on the Mylar square left. Everything is on the surface of the glass. I'm going to go ahead and use a little bit of water, sprinkle it over it, and I'm going to scrape the resin off the surface of the glass. I want to make sure that when I scrape it, I don't use it in a indirect angle, like a 45 or 35 degree. I want to come in at a 90 degree and actually scrape it off. All right, now that I've scraped that off, I'm gonna go ahead and wipe the moisture and the residue of the actual dried up resin. And now I'm gonna get my polish, and I'm gonna put a drop of polish right over the brake. Make sure to cap my polish back. And I'm gonna use a paper towel and just buff it up really good. I'm going in a circular motion, and then, as you can hear it, kind of squeaky sound, I am buffing resin to make it nice and clear. That is our repair with our Rockstar Roadie. As you can see, using the Rockstar Roadie gives you a quality repair.